Okay, the last part for this chapter, guys. Last part for this chapter. Reactivity of metals. Let's have this kind of exact. Calcium, as you must already know, is one of the very, very reactive metals. Pinens, pots, clap. Then got mesil, co. So where does calcium come? Calcium is here. So very reactive metal. So you're learning this, I want to give you this idea so that because next year when you learn chemistry and everything, this becomes like a basic for you, okay? How carbonates become oxides, how oxide can become hydroxide, how hydroxide can become even more with more water, so it can become solutions and everything. Then what are the chemical reactions that happen here, plusing, adding water, heating and all that, okay? So let's start this, guys. Calcium carbonate, what is calcium carbonate? Calcium carbonate is a compound that has got calcium, got carbon, got oxygen presently, got calcium, got carbon, got oxygen presently in that. Calcium carbonate, easy to find, I tell you where you can find. Seashells are calcium carbonate. Eggshells are the easiest lah. Eggshells, their eggshells are calcium carbonate. So calcium carbonate, kalau you panaskan calcium carbonate juga dikenali sebagai limestone, also known as limestone. You heat up, some books will just show you the symbol, triangle symbol here. So triangle symbol, so heat ataupun tulis heat here. Calcium carbonate kalau dipanaskan, heat up calcium carbonate, you get calcium oxide. Plus, it will produce carbon dioxide. Will produce carbon dioxide. So, example here, guys. Eggshell, 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 eggshell. Panaskan the eggshell. When you panaskan the eggshell, that means what are we heating up here? We're heating up the calcium carbonate. It will produce calcium oxide. It will become darker, blacker in color. And not only that, no, guys. Not only that. Lime water. Lime water is not lime juice. Lime water is air kapur. Okay, lime water, which will be clear, will become cloudy. Clear lime water will become cloudy. Why does clear lime water become cloudy here? Because the CO2, carbon dioxide, if got carbon dioxide present, maka lime water from clear will become cloudy. From clear will become cloudy. Then. So, you can test the presence of carbon dioxide by using lime water. Lime water is not limau juice, not lemon water. This one is lime water, is air kapur. Okay, air kapur. Later you come to the lime water here. So, but there, this is the lime water. Okay, now, so calcium carbonate, panaskan, becomes calcium oxide, release carbon dioxide. How to prove got carbon dioxide? Use lime water. Second one, take the calcium oxide. Put some water, there will be a hissing sound. Hissing sound, right? Hissing sound, that means got chemical reaction happening there. Then it will form calcium hydroxide. Also known as slate lime. Limestone, calcium carbonate, quick lime, calcium oxide, quick lime. Put more water, put water into quick lime or calcium oxide, then become slate lime. All these are the common terms that we can use other than the calcium oxide, calcium hydroxide, right? Example, calcium hydroxide is also known as the slate lime. You take slate lime and it's also known as calcium hydroxide. Put more water, put inside nicely, mix with tamba a lot of water. Then becomes a solution, calcium hydroxide solution. Calcium hydroxide solution is also known as lime water. Lime water. So you can take this lime water and test for the presence of carbon dioxide. How again? Let's just say I want to see you breathe out carbon dioxide, right? So put a straw ataupun got lime water here. You blow into that lime water there. Lime water that is clear will become cloudy, also known as becoming chalky, cloudy or chalky. Yeah. So that means got presence of carbon dioxide. Okay, can I guys clear on this? Calcium carbonate, panaskan jadi calcium oxide, akan membebaskan carbon dioxide. Boleh test dengan menggunakan lime water there, guys. Calcium oxide, put more water, drops of water, there will be hissing sound. The hissing sound indicates there's a chemical reaction, so becomes calcium hydroxide. Take the calcium hydroxide, put more water, then got calcium hydroxide solution there, also known as lime water. Okay, all these reactions step by step, already passed you the worksheet there. The worksheet got the reaction by reaction. So just to be clear, this is the chemical reactions that you must know. Okay, all this later on you will learn in chemistry lah, guys. Ganti the calcium katakan dengan magnesium carbonate ke, or potassium carbonate ke, sodium carbonate ke, that one all later lah. Okay, how the formation occurs, how salt formation, all later. But now part of this chapter, settle this as well. Okay, one more thing, let's one shot settle, guys. It's also in your worksheet there. So I'm done, guys. The next part. Okay. here, the board of each. Okay. Now here, this one is related to silicon. Silicon, one example, guys, learn this, one example that you learn, which is a non-metal. So far, I'm always talking about metal, right? So this one is a non-metal and is the second most abundant metal on Earth's crust, in Earth there, guys. Example, sand. Sand is actually a silicon compound. Silicon compound, I think only, silicon, first of all, let's clear this. Silicon secara asasnya, very reactive. Anything you hear already, very reactive, means the fella cannot keep quiet, very gatal, will go and combine with something. So, silicon will always, you cannot find pure silicon. Silicon, you cannot find pure silicon there. Silicon will always already combine with something. Why? Because it's very reactive. Anything that is very reactive won't keep quiet. It always go and combine with something, cannot keep quiet. The fella very gatal, go and combine with something there. So, example here, silicon plus oxygen will give you silica. You get silica. Silicon, oxygen, you get silica. Silicon plus oxygen and metal there, you get silicates. So what is silica and silicate? Silica is a combination of silicon plus oxygen. Silicates got T, got metal, got T. So silicates means, that means got metal present inside. Silica and silicate are examples of silicon compounds. The thing about this, I want you to be clear is what, guys? Silicon itself is very, very reactive. That means the fella cannot be found originally just as silicon. Always will go and combine with something else. But once it's already combined, becomes silicate, then it becomes very stable. So, story just like this only. Before, when the fella is single, the fella cannot keep quiet. Must go and combine with something. Must get married. Marry with oxygen, then become silica. Marry with oxygen and metal, then become silicates. But once it's already married, right? Then becomes very, very stable. The fella very secure, never break off, loves its partner, not easy to separate them. You put inside water, cannot dissolve in water. I've given you all the points properly. Guys, you know, check. I cannot dissolve the water. Cannot decompose. When heated, you cannot decompose. Third one, does not react. Does not react with acid. So, cannot dissolve in water. Does not decompose when heated. Does not react with acid. Why? Because the fella already become very, very stable. Before combined, very reactive. After combined, silica, silicate, contoh, silicon compound, becomes very, very stable now. Okay, so this is just two small parts. So you settle, already finished. I've given you a lot of latihan there, a little bit more. That was not enough actually. Do extra, a bit more. Okay, so the next chapter. So chapter 4 done, guys. So chapter 4 already done. This is a very, very important chapter, basic chapter for chemistry. Not just for PT3 exams, guys. For basic for next year, whether you're in science stream, art stream, does not matter. Science, basic science in 4-4, 4-5, or you take chemistry next year means. All these are the basics that you will learn. You must know. Okay, so be clear on it. Do more latihan there. I'll try to give you a little bit more extra latihan from time to time. As we go on to the next chapter, chapter 5, which is the thermochemistry part. Okay, that's all, guys. Stay safe. That's all. Take care. Bye bye.